Happy Wednesday, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you all so much for joining this wonderful day of January 20th, 2021. I am Meteorologist Sam Kenny, and first and foremost, I want to deeply apologize once again for my audio issues. Most of you know that I did a video a few days ago, and I informed you all that I was receiving an adapter today that would allow me to use my wireless microphone and my lavalier, my clip-on microphone, on my iPhone. It did arrive, but unfortunately, it does not work. For my phone, I have no idea why. I'm probably as annoyed as you are about it. But thankfully, it does work with my dad's phone. It also does work with my iPad, and I'm looking into purchasing a tripod for my iPad. So just know I am doing everything I can to get all my audio issues resolved. But in this broadcast, I will give you the latest forecast for the end of this week, the forecast for this week, and then also a look at the forecast for the early parts of next week as far as Monday goes. There's going to be one main system that has been affecting the southwestern parts of the country as we've gone throughout this week, and that will eventually track to the east and bring a very rainy and dirty and messy end to this week, and also and then we'll be watching another system that will impact the eastern coast as we go into Monday. So here's the current look at our National Weather Radar. Here's our main system right here. It's brought much needed rain to several parts of the southwest. I was watching the Weather Channel last night, and some places have gone over 300 days of no rainfall. Can y'all imagine, sitting, outside and not having rain for 300 days straight? I can't even imagine that. So very needed rain here in the southwestern parts of the country. And we're still dealing with some shower action just because an area of low pressure right here, all throughout the Grand Strand and also the southeast today, gorgeous day. And then we're still dealing with some lake effect snow up here in the Midwest and the Northeast. Here's a better look here in the Northeast. Watertown, New York was seeing a lot of lake effect snow yesterday. In and around from Cleveland, Ohio, all the way up to Buffalo, in between that area, we're going to be potentially watching to see around 8 to 12 inches of snow. This is right along the lake. As you all can see, Albany, New York's now getting into some of that snow action. Pittsburgh, just basically in the middle of a snow band that is just to the south and north of you. So scattered lake effect snow showers throughout the day today. Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, right on that mixing line of snow and rain. And then as you work your way back into New England, partly cloudy today, some snow showers and extreme western Massachusetts. Here's a better look here in the southeast. Gorgeous day for you in Atlanta, Georgia. Same for you in Charleston, South Carolina, and Charlotte, North Carolina. And as you work your way back down into Florida, into the Florida Peninsula, Tampa, Orlando, Miami, Jacksonville, gorgeous day for you. Same for you in Birmingham, Alabama, New Orleans, Louisiana, gorgeous day for you. Some clouds around in Shreveport, Louisiana, just because of the system right here. A very yucky and rainy day for you there in Dallas, Texas. Houston, Texas might be a little cloudy today. Might see some few showers in the afternoon. Corpus Christi, looks like there are just showers to the southeast, right along that border of Texas and Mexico. But as we work our way throughout the rest of this afternoon and then eventually tomorrow, we will start to see the system bring to a little bit closer to the east, bringing possible rain to some places like Shreveport, Louisiana, Lake Charles, one of the areas that was very heavily affected by Hurricane Laura last year, possibly into Memphis, Tennessee, central parts of Mississippi, even into you as we go into New Orleans, Louisiana, as we go into tomorrow. Here's a better look here in the central U.S., a gorgeous day, but a chilly day for you in North Platte, Nebraska, Wichita, Kansas, Kansas City, Kansas, gorgeous day for you, Des Moines, Iowa, Sioux City, gorgeous day for you. Denver, Colorado, there'll probably be a lot of sunshine out there today. Still on the chillier side just because you're very high in elevation. Grand Junction, still a gorgeous day for you. Might be some snow showers just to the south of you there. Santa Fe, it'll be a snowy day for you. You can see all those showers ripping their way around the Santa Fe area. And then here, a better look here in the southwest. Once again, very needed rain here. We're talking several areas possibly like Flagstaff and Phoenix, Arizona, going around maybe 200 to 270 days of no rainfall. So extremely an exceptional drought here in the southwest. You all know that we've been experiencing a lot of wildfires this year, a lot of deadly wildfires. One of the worst years for wildfires ever in the record book. So very needed rain here because of a big area of low pressure here. I'll show you that in just a second. But once again, very needed rain here as we go into southwestern New Mexico. Here's a current look at our current satellite map. Here's our big area of low pressure, once again bringing that very needed rain to some parts of the southwest. Here's that big area of, another area of low pressure that's been bringing rain to central parts of Texas. As I said, a gorgeous day because of this very, dry cold front that is working their way into the southeast. And then there's that lake effect snow because of that other low pressure system. So we've got a lot of, low pressure systems and high pressure systems that are currently working their way through the country right now, bringing, very needed rain to the southwest and possibly some scattered showers and thunderstorms as you work your way throughout the day here in Central Texas. Here's the forecast for the rest of today. As I said, showers because of that area of low pressure, some snow showers here in New Mexico, very needed rain, thankfully, in some parts of Arizona, working their way back into South California. All throughout the Southeast and the Gulf Coast, a gorgeous day for you. New Orleans, Louisiana, topping at 68. Atlanta, Georgia, 55. Charlotte, North Carolina, 54. And then we're still going to be dealing with that lake effect snow up here in the Mid-Atlantic and the Northeast. New York, mix of sunshine and clouds today, topping out at 40. Washington, D.C., topping out at 46. Chicago, gorgeous day for you. Still on the chilly side, topping out right at that freezing mark. Minneapolis, Minnesota, snow showers just to the north of you. Mix of sunshine and clouds today, topping out at 38. And then as you work your way back towards the west, Los Angeles, California, a gorgeous day for you. Plenty of sunshine, topping out at 78. San Francisco, California, topping out at 64 with a mix of sunshine and clouds. And as you work your way throughout Thursday, we're still going to be watching this area of low pressure starting to push now to the east. As you all can see, we have a very consistent line of rain that stretches that stretches way from the western part of Texas all the way into the central parts of Georgia and then possibly even into the Carolinas. So as you go into Thursday, January 21st, mix of sunshine clouds for you in New Orleans. Mostly cloudy, topping out at 73. Possibly some scattered showers around for you in Corpus Christi, topping out at 70 degrees. Atlanta, Georgia, topping out 55 with a possibly some sunshine and clouds. Charlotte, North Carolina, mix of sunshine and clouds. Mostly cloudy, topping out 57. Washington, D.C., plenty of sunshine, topping out at 53. And then as you work your way into the end of the week on Friday, January 22nd, this low pressure system will be a very slow mover. So as we go through our Wednesday, Thursday, and eventually into Friday, this system will be a very slow mover. It'll still be here, affecting the Gulf Coast and the Southeast as you get into Friday. Plenty of rain out there for you in Atlanta, Georgia, topping out at 52. Charlotte, North Carolina, we're still on that cloudy side. No rain yet. We probably won't look into that rain until you really go into Saturday and Sunday. Plenty of rain for you in Boston, New York, and Washington, D.C. Boston, New York, topping out in the low 50s. Washington, D.C., topping out in the high 40s. Chicago, Illinois, a very chilly day. Plenty of sunshine out there. Still on the very chilly side, topping out at 23 degrees, so very, very chilly. Kansas City, topping out at 38. Denver, Colorado, topping out at 47. And Albuquerque, New Mexico, topping out at 51. And this will be our next system that will work its way into the eventually into the Saturday as you go into Sunday and Monday. Here's your look at Saturday, a gorgeous day for the whole entire eastern part of the country. Plenty of sunshine, basically everywhere. We'll be on the chilly side just because of that cold front coming through. We will start to see these temperatures drop down about 5 to 10 degrees below average, but plenty of snow all the way across the western tier of the country. Salt Lake City, Utah, getting into some of that snow. Rapid City, South Dakota. Minneapolis, Minnesota, very chilly and raw day. Plenty of snow showers out there, topping out at 20 degrees. So we're probably talking about wind chills probably in the teens, possibly single digits. So very, very chilly. Most of the rain has now worked its way out of Central Texas, still in, which is a few scattered showers. Dallas, Texas, plenty of cloud cover out there, topping out at 61. And Corpus Christi, topping out at 73. And then here's your better look at Sunday. A very messy day for the whole entire central and eastern parts of the country. Right along the coast, right along the I-95 corridor, where it'll be still be sunny. But right along the central part of the country, as you go back into the Ohio River Valley, plenty of rain out there. It looks like Chicago, Illinois, that will be the leading edge. If you're going to be north of that, if you're going to be north of Chicago, it'll be all snow. And if you're obviously south of Chicago, that will be where it'll be all rain. So Chicago, Illinois, one of those areas that will be right on that leading edge, topping out at 34, a mix of sunshine and snow, topping out at 34. Kansas City, plenty of rain out there, very raw day, topping out at 44. Nashville, Tennessee, a little bit on the chilly side, topping at 51 with a mix of sunshine and clouds, possibly a few scattered showers out there. And then as we go into Dallas, Texas, plenty of thunderstorm activity, possibly even a severe threat, topping out at 68. And can't forget about you in Corpus Christi, very warm day, topping out at 79 with plenty of thunderstorms out there. Even for you in New Orleans, topping out at 75. So very warm temperatures as you go throughout Sunday and Monday. And then as you go into Monday, this system basically is still sold out. Now we're starting to see some of this rain action now working its way towards the East Coast. Atlanta, Georgia, now getting into that, some of that rain action. Same for you in Charlotte, North Carolina, Washington, D.C., another area that will be also seeing rain. Temperatures in the north will be steady in the mid-40s, and as you work your way back down towards the south, Atlanta, Georgia, topping out at 65, New Orleans, topping out at 75, Charlotte, North Carolina, topping out at 55, Nashville, Tennessee, topping out at 61. And once again, you know, Kansas City will be one of those, you know, cities that on Monday will be on the leading edge of that front, you know, basically deciding who will get snow and rain. So on Monday, Kansas City topping out at 36, a mix of rain and snow, so very raw day. And we're going to be watching another system working its way into the western coast. So system after system after system, okay? Here's your 10-day forecast for the Grand Strand. A gorgeous rest of your day for you along the Grand Strand, topping out 60 degrees, a mix of sunshine and clouds today. As you work your way into tomorrow and eventually into Friday, that will be when that next weather maker starts to work its way into our area, bringing us a 20% chance of rain tomorrow and a 40% chance of rain on Friday. Both days topping out in the mid to high 50s. And as you work your way into the weekend, a gorgeous weekend, temperatures topping out in the low 50s. And then Monday, that will be our next weather maker that will bring us a 50% chance of rain on Monday, topping out at 64. And then here's your 10-day forecast for inland counties. Gorgeous rest of your day for you, mix of sunshine and clouds, topping out at 60 degrees. Thursday and Friday will be our rainy days. You have a better chance of rain on Friday with a 40% chance of rain and only a 20% chance of rain tomorrow. But temperatures will be steady in the mid-50s. And as you work your way back into the weekend, plenty of sunshine, temperatures topping out in the low to mid-50s. And as you work your way into the early parts of next week, that's where we're going to be finding our next weather maker. 50% chance of rain, temperatures topping out in the mid-60s. So that is all I have for you all today. Thank you all so much for watching. Once again, I deeply apologize for all my audio issues that I've been having. You know, hopefully I can get this audio issue resolved. Whenever I'm recording with my dad's phone or my iPad, I guarantee you that I will be using my microphone and my audio quality will be much, much better. So thank you all for staying with me and, you know, trusting me to bring you all up to date on the latest information possible. I cannot stress this enough. Please, please, please be sure that you are checking into both my YouTube channel and my website at least daily, so that way you do not miss out on a single video. You all know that every single video that I post on YouTube goes directly to my website. And then please also be sure that you are following me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter for the latest weather updates. So that is all I have for you all today. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you all have a great rest of your day.